Welcome to Crayola Creativity Week. Today's theme is connecting past and future. Our special guests are Eva Chen and Sophie Diao. Eva, please introduce yourself and tell us how your childhood experiences have influenced how you express your creativity today.
I'm Eva Chen, and I'm so excited to be here as part of Crayola's Creativity Week. Growing up, I was surrounded by creativity in so many different ways. My parents came to New York City from Taiwan, and they had to learn to live in a whole new country. And that takes a lot of creative and brave thinking. My mom loved fashion and found a way to make it part of her job by working with jewelry. I like to think that I inherited my mother's love of fashion. And even though I studied to become a doctor, I realized my creative talents were in writing and fashion, so it was natural for me to become a fashion editor and a children's book author.
Sophie, please introduce yourself and tell us when and why you decided to become an artist.
Hi, I'm Sophie Diao, and I always liked to draw ever since I was a little kid. Ever since I could pick up a pencil or a crayon, I was drawing all the time. I was really lucky in that my parents supported me and wanted me to pursue my artistic interest. So they signed me up for art classes and, you know, gave me the opportunities to practice my artwork. And then eventually I decided to go to college to study animation to do art as a professional career.
Eva, please read the book, I Am Golden.
So I Am Golden is actually the eighth book I've written, but I would say that this is my most personal book because it's very much the story of my family and me and my experience growing up. It's the story of a young girl named May. So the brave and creative thinking that I mentioned earlier, Aoki, is very much present in this book, I Am Golden. I'm very excited to share it with you. We named you May. Not May like the month, May, which means beautiful, like the country we live in now, Meiguo, America. What do you see when you look in the mirror, May? Do you see beauty? We see eyes that point toward the sun, that give us the warmth and joy of a thousand rays when you smile. We see hair as inky black and smooth as a peaceful night sky. We see skin brushed with gold. We see the hopes and dreams of your ancestors when we look at you. We journeyed into the unknown to give you a new path to trailblaze. In this upside-down world, clever child, you have become our teacher and translator. Our words won't always be enough to comfort you, and we won't be able to be with you every step of the way. We know you feel alone sometimes. People tell you that you're different, and that you can't be one of them. But we promise there is power in being different. Are you ready, brave May, to hear about your secret power? You are never alone. You carry a golden flame inside you, and it's always with you. You are made of dragons, of phoenixes, of jade rabbits, and of monkey kings. You are the lotus flower unfurling, triumphant and bright, in the darkest water. You are the first bamboo stalk, piercing the soil that will overtake the sky. Your voice is the call of the magpie, joyful and unapologetic. It's a strange world we live in. People will call you different with one breath and then say we all look the same with the next angry breath. But they don't know that each of our golden flames flickers distinctly, that our stories are infinitely unique. We are artists, scientists, athletes. We are dancers, teachers, inventors. We are architects, actors, writers. You can hear all our stories when we gather as a family. There will be celebrations, oh, we love to celebrate, with plate upon plate of delectable deliciousness that will tickle all your senses. The hot pop and sizzle of garlic in a wok, the lazy curls of steam from freshly kneaded bao, the sesame balls that will leave your fingers slick and sweet. We gather to hope, to dream, and to sing your praises, May, to send love to your popo and gonggong who are not in Meiguo with us, to pay tribute to those we've loved and lost along the way, as oceans and worlds and cultures separated us. Have we taught you the word Ming yet? It means destiny, Mei. Our destiny was you. Our Ming is to be the keepers of your flame, to guide you as best we can. We see you. We see your golden heart. You are beauty, but so much more. You are strength. You are power. You, Mei, are golden. Say it with us. Believe it. I am golden.
Wow, what a great story. You also wrote a new book, We Are Golden. Please tell us about this book and read a few stories about changemakers.
So I Am Golden is very much a personal book. It's about my story, my family story, and it's about one girl named Mei. We Are Golden is about different changemakers from different paths of life. We have designers, we have astronauts, we have athletes. And so today I'll be sharing a few mini biographies from We Are Golden. And the first one today is Patsy Mink. Her life was full of firsts. The Japanese American was the first Asian American to run for US president and the first Asian American woman and woman of color to be elected to Congress. As a member of the US House of Representatives, she spearheaded important bills such as Title IX, which prohibits sex discrimination in educational programs, the Early Childhood Education Act, and the Women's Educational Equity Act. Mabel Minghua. At age 16, despite facing barriers because of her gender and her race, this Chinese-born suffragist helped lead nearly 10,000 people on a march for voting rights. She was also the first Chinese woman to earn a PhD in economics. I M. Pei. Using his striking modern style, this Chinese architect designed over 50 buildings around the world, including the iconic glass pyramid at the Louvre Museum in Paris, France. Each and every one of you watching this is a changemaker in your own way. So you might want to start by asking a grown-up around you, what can I do to help? It might be something small. There's so many different ways to make change, but you will find that the smallest changes can add up to big impact.
Thank you, Eva. Sophie, how did your childhood influence the approach you took to illustrating both of these golden stories?
So when I was a kid, my family and I would often go back to China during the summers to visit my cousins, my aunts, my grandparents. And I have a lot of great memories from visiting everyone in China. And so when we were illustrating I Am Golden and I was working with Eva to try to bring her words to life, I was drawing upon a lot of childhood memories. And I've infused a lot of that into the book, illustrating old photographs of family members, illustrating delicious Chinese family meals, illustrating scenes of Mei's grandparents and Mei and her parents talking to each other over the phone, over a video chat from oceans away. So that was all based on my own experience growing up.
Eva, please explain how heritage and legacy are threads that connect these two books.
Well, I Am Golden really focuses on how each individual is filled with infinite potential that builds upon those who have come before us. And heritage is important in every culture. So even when children are unclear about their specific family history, they can think about those who may have influenced them, helped them to carve a path, guided them on big decisions, and been alongside them for life's whole journey. Finally, legacy is what we leave behind. When I was at Lucky Magazine, I was actually the youngest editor-in-chief in the magazine's history. And I've also written for a lot of publications, from Vogue to the New York Times to the Wall Street Journal and Teen Vogue. Right now, I'm the head of fashion at Instagram, but also, most importantly to me, the author of 9 children's books that I hope will be passed on from generation to generation. This is all part of my legacy, and I want readers to remember some of the big ideas from these books. First thing is finding your creative voice. Sometimes it takes time. Just know that every time you try something and try to express yourself, whether it's through drawing, whether it's through dance, you are on a journey to find your creative voice, and every single action adds up. I also want you to remember that it's okay to feel different. It's okay to feel like you don't fit in. You will find your place. You will find the people who see you for who you are, and it's all part of your journey.
Thank you, Eva. Sophie, please show our viewers how to create a personal timeline called My Family and My Future, which begins with those who came before us and then branches into some future possibilities.
We're going to create a personal life map. We're going to draw May or yourself in the middle, and then we're going to draw the people who came before us, and then we're going to draw the possible, you know, paths that our life might take in the future. And so I'm gonna draw my childhood self, myself as a little kid. So here I am in the center. I'm gonna give myself the bob, the black hair. And then we're going to talk about the things that came before us that represent the people who made us possible. So I'm going to draw my grandma and my grandpa. My grandma has a lot of wrinkles and she has a big smile. And my grandpa, he also liked to smile a lot. I remember him always smiling and singing songs, and he had some pet birds. I'm gonna draw some of the birds that my grandpa had. And then I'm gonna draw some of my art teachers. So the art teachers that I've had in my life have been so supportive and so kind. And without them, I probably wouldn't be where I am today. So PJ, my first art teacher, I'm gonna symbolize her by drawing an easel and drawing an art palette on the easel. So right now I'm going to add the little paint swatches. That's it. And then the last symbol I want to add to the left side of my life map, I think I'm going to add some plants, because when I was a kid, my parents and I would go hiking a lot. And so I'm going to represent that by drawing a plant. And so you can think about, you know, when you're drawing the left side of your life map, what are the things that are important to you, and who maybe came before you and who taught you something that you really value today. So for the next part of the life map, we're going to draw what we imagine for ourselves in the future. I would imagine that I had a dog because I really wanted a dog. I'm going to draw myself with a dog in the future. And so you can think about, like, what's something that you really want to have happen? What's something that you have as a goal? And how are you going to represent it in your life map? And then the next thing I'm going to think about for my future, for me, I'm going to draw that I am illustrating more picture books, because that's something that I have as a goal for myself, to illustrate more picture books. And that's like a big part of my career now. So here I am with my picture books. As part of my life map. And make sure when you're drawing your life map, you're thinking about what you really want. You imagine for yourself, like, what's something that you are really interested in? Like, don't just copy mine. Everyone has their own personal journey. So you can think about, like, what is it that you want for your career? You could be an astronaut, you could be a teacher, you could be a doctor. And then for the last part of my future in the life map, I'm going to draw myself going on a vacation. On the beach. And so, you know, maybe you can draw something. You can think about, like, what's something you want to do for fun? You know, life isn't all about work. I know we talked about our jobs just now and, like, our future careers, but life isn't all about work, and you can draw what things you want to do to have fun. Maybe you want to play a sport. Maybe you want to learn an instrument. Maybe you want to, you know, have an adventure. We have the past. We have the present. And then we have our futures. And with that, we have finished our life maps. I hope you all are very proud of the ones that you've done today. This is the My Family, My Future activity. And thank you so much for following along with me today.
Sophie, We Are Golden features many great thought leaders who remind us that we can all be change makers. Please demonstrate a fun way to sketch how we are inspired by and supported by others.
A change maker is somebody who, you know, has such a big impact on the world that there's something that is different because of them. And so as we think about the change makers in our lives, we're going to draw ourselves once again, standing on the shoulders of the change makers who came before us. I'm going to draw myself here, kind of in the top right area, so we have room for drawing someone beside and beneath us. Here's my childhood hair once again. And my overalls. And when you're drawing, you can think about, like, what's something that you really like to wear. And we're going to fill in this area with somebody who came before me, somebody who I would consider a change maker, who's really important to me and who paved the way for where I am today. And so I'm thinking about, you know, I'm thinking about We Are Golden, our book, and I'm thinking about all the amazing people who are in there. And I'm thinking about, honestly, Eva. Like, Eva is a really, really amazing person. And so when you're doing your own changemaker activity, you can either think about somebody who inspires you, or you can think about, you know, it could be somebody you don't really know, like a celebrity who you really admire. Or it could be somebody who, you know, you do know, like someone in your family, someone who has given you good advice in the past, maybe one of your teachers, someone who just makes your day a little bit better. And that's what we're really focusing on today, is making sure that we honor the people who have done a good job of supporting the next generation of artists and writers and change makers, including yourselves. And what's important to remember is that you don't have to wait until you're grown up to be a change maker. You can start today. Making a change can be as simple as saying thank you, being polite, helping others when they're down. Being a kid is just as great an opportunity to be a change maker as being a grown up. And so, there you have it. This is the Changemakers activity. This is my myself sitting on the shoulders of Eva, who I consider to be a changemaker. And thank you so much for following along.
Sophie and Eva, thank you for showing us how connecting the past and future helps us think about our heritage and legacy.
Thank you so much, Aoki, and thank you to all the kids who are watching. I hope you had an amazing creativity week. See you next time. Bye.
Thank you, Aoki, and thank you everyone who's watching today. Goodbye.
Parents and educators, be sure to check out more creative ideas at crayola.com/creativityweek. And remember to share kids' artwork. Post a photo on social media using hashtag Crayola Creativity Week for a chance to win today's amazing giveaway.